has been built on top of for the last several hundred years. What do you think the White House is sitting on? And, but they couldn't get it because they were looking at the narrow little paragraph on their big, thick book and their world. And some of them really believed they were trying to help me out. I've had other architects, structural engineers, and other licensed state inspectors that didn't have a previously scheduled agenda, as the defense attorney was trying to point out in our case today with Vernon, like they went there with the idea of making sure that they would shut Vernon's operation down. I don't know even that much about it, but I come to believe it because I'm figuring out how regulators work and that there's hidden agendas behind the scene. But these other people that didn't have a biased opinion openly looked at our buildings and have told me time and time again, these are way better than code. They're way overbuilt. They're way stronger. And they're gorgeous and interesting. And you really built that for $27? And it's like, yeah, it was just the nails and the chainsaw fuel, and everything else is hand carved and hand fit together with an axe and an adze and care, just like all of our ancestors have done. And I don't know too much about computers. I stay away from them other than friends that work with me have the web page, and they've told me about this thing called Facebook. And so this morning, with a borrowed cell phone that I didn't even know how to use yesterday, they handed it to me when I was on the airplane, and I felt like a bad student when they showed me over and over how to make it work coming in and going out. So I had this borrowed cell phone, and this morning I actually made it ring down there, and I spent the before daylight hours writing out some stuff that I thought was important about this trial with Vernon. And one of the things that I pointed out and put on Facebook to go out to hopefully tens of thousands of people to help raise consciousness, which is one of the things that I think is most important about you being here now and Vernon taking a stance, even though it's a hard struggle for him and his family and his community, it has to be done. And I put in this writing this one point from a cultural anthropological perspective to try to back up and get some idea about what this is about. It's like what Vernon is doing here, sharing healthy food, is what all farmers through all time have done on all continents. That's a fairly inclusive statement and equated there. That means 100% of all of our ancestors have done this thing. But right now, in the home of the brave, in the land of the free, a man is on trial.